hard with you and Billy the Kid. Always on the go, eat every meal with one foot in the air ready to jump.
Why don't you tell your troubles to Billy? He'll be along directly.
I sure will. We'll stay right here and rest up. The sheriff don't know where we are, and I can at least be at ease for a while. Yet every sheriff in the state's looking for him. It ain't right. Besides, it's ruining my digestion. First peaceful moment I've had in 3 months.
Saddle your horses, boys. I'm three cups of coffee. Come on, Fuzzy can eat later.
Here we go again.
Hurry, I'll keep the Fuzzy entertained. Why don't we stay and fight him?
No, we don't want any bloodshed.
That sheriff is only doing his duty. Go on.
Big time, but
well, this bridge getting harder all the time.
I'm the guy who's hungry around here.
See if you can sneak around behind him.
We're not stopping for lunch.
Well, no fool sheriff's going to stop me from having my lunch.
Shut up, huh?
Is that the wound you've been yelling about? From listening to you, I thought we're going to have to amputate your leg.
Suppose you keep your opinion to yourself if someone asks you for it. If I feel like complaining, I'll complain. If you don't enjoy listening to it, well, go stick your head in the sand.
Oh, what's the matter, Fuzzy? You sound like you're kind of touchy.
Oh, I'm getting doggone tired of living the life of a jackrabbit on the half hop all the time. If anybody robs a bank within 40 miles of where we are, we get the blame for it.
Yeah, that's true enough. You know, you give a fellow a bad name and he comes in mighty handy to hang things on. Bet someone was sure and happy when this little fellow showed up missing.
Yeah. Say, I noticed quite a family resemblance to Fuzzy.
You know, now that you mention it, so do I.
But Bill, don't you think this one looks a little more intelligent?
Huh?
Let me see that.
Fellas sound like a couple of magpies that show half as much sense.
Look at him over there.
I got it. Just what I've been looking for.
What have you been looking for? This. Now listen.
Fertile Paradise Valley will soon be the garden spot of the West. For a small fee, the Paradise Land and Development Company will locate you on a choice homestead where, in years to come, you can sit at ease beneath your own vine and fig tree while Mother Nature produces a bountiful harvest for you. That's what I yearn for. To sit under my own vine and fig tree and let Mother Nature produce.
Wake up, Fuzzy. You're no dirt farmer.
You may look like a groundhog, but you ain't one at heart.
Maybe not. But I want peace and quiet where I can sit down and eat a decent meal without having some sheriff interrupt me before I'm half through. And I'm a-going right now.
Is he kidding?
I think he's serious. I hate to see you pulling out, Fuzzy. Been a long way together.
My constitution's plumb fed up on excitement. Why don't you come with me, Billy, and pick up a homestead? Maybe get married.
No, thanks. I can't see myself wrangling squash and potatoes and riding herd on a field of alfalfa.
You know, Fuzzy, if you've got any idea that you're going to find any time to sit under a fig tree, you're local. Dirt farming is a full-time job.
Maybe it is. But I at least don't have to eat a meal with one hand and throw lead with the other. Bye, Billy.
So long, Fuzzy. You know where to find us if you ever change your mind.
Sure do. Bye, Fuzzy, and good luck.
Same to you, Jeff. When you get yourself shot full of holes and all crippled up, why, come on over and sit under my fig tree for a spell.
All right.
Well, adios.
Funny, I guess I'll miss old Fuzzy.
So will I. You know, he could make more fool mistakes than any two ordinary men. Yet I'd trust him with my life.